Catholic News World.
Saint Cecilia, who died in 117 AD, was virgin and martyr of the church. The holy legend of Saint Cecilia has been celebrated since the late 4th century. Saint Cecilia is the patron saint of liturgical music and the patron saint of musicians, composers, instrument makers, and poets. From her acta, while the profane music of her wedding was heard, Cecilia was singing in her heart a hymn of love for Jesus, her true spouse. Cecilia was born in the early part of the 3rd century, in Rome. Born to wealthy, pagan parents, she was probably instructed in the Catholic faith by kind relatives or a nurse. By all reports, as a child, Cecilia loved music, and she would spend her days singing the praises of God, accompanying herself on different instruments. Cecilia embraced the faith from childhood. Drawn to the Lord, she attended Mass daily, desiring nothing more than to embody the virtues of Christ: faith, hope, charity, humility, and purity. As a child, she consecrated herself a bride of Christ, pledging her perpetual virginity to the Lord. There were no religious orders for women at that time in history. Cecilia fasted, prayed, and wore sackcloth each day, while she spent her days in charitable works, caring for the poor and needy. Her parents found a husband for her to marry, an honest man, Valerian, who was pagan. She wished to obey her parents, but she had made a vow of virginity to the Lord. She spent her days and nights in prayer. As her wedding day approached, she did little but pray. The Lord promised to send an angel to Saint Cecilia, to guard her, and to assist her in keeping her vow. Cecilia was married in an extravagant ceremony, internally, in her soul, becoming the bride of Christ. After the ceremony, Cecilia said to her new earthly husband, "Dear friend, I have a secret to confide to you." Valerian was at first surprised. "Go to Pope Urban," she instructed him. "When you tell the poor that you are Cecilia's friend, they will take you to see the Pope. He will explain to you the mysteries of the Catholic faith. May God bless you and my angel protect you." Valerian traveled to see Pope Urban that very evening. He was converted to Catholicism and baptized into the faith. He returned to his new bride, finding her accompanied by the angel she had promised. The angel, as emissary from the Lord, bestowed upon them both the golden crowns of heaven. Together, they lived in celibacy and grew in love for the Lord, eventually converting Valerian's brother, Tiburtius, a man of some importance in Rome. Together the brothers made it their mission to find and provide a decent burial to the Christian martyrs being executed throughout Rome. It was not long, however, until the governor of Rome, learning of their Christianity through Tiburtius, summoned the brothers before him. When questioned, they refused to recant their faith, stating, "We are Christians and we believe in Jesus Christ, the one and only true God." Upon hearing this, the governor ordered them martyred. Saint Cecilia, assisted by her angel, recovered and buried the bodies. But soon, she was called before the governor as well. Courageously, she, too, declared her faith, "I too am a Christian and I believe in Jesus Christ, the one and only true God." The governor sentenced her to death, stating, "Cecilia, you are condemned to die for loving the poor and for adoring Christ crucified." The soldiers tried to scald and suffocated her in the steam bath in her own home, but rather than suffer, she could be heard singing to the Lord, seemingly accompanied by the choir of angels. After 36 hours, in which she should not have been able to survive, she was released. The governor then ordered her head cut off, but the guard who attempted sliced her neck 3 times with a sword, but was unable to sever it. Scared, he ran away, leaving her wounded and in great pain. Cecilia survived for 3 days, bleeding and injured, but cared for by her angel and the Christians in the small community that had developed. During that time, she preached, converting many, gave away all that she had to the poor, and prayed incessantly. On the last day of her life, Pope Urban traveled to her home, bestowing upon her the last rites, and seeing her to heaven. On her wishes, Pope Urban ordered Cecilia's house converted into a church, with the steam bath, the site of the start of her martyrdom, the chapel. Nearly 800 years later, in 1599, the tomb of Saint Cecilia was opened, and her body was found to be perfectly preserved and incorrupt. At that time, a sculptor was called in to examine and sculpt the body prior to resealing the tomb. A likeness was made with the following carved into the floor at the altar at the base of the statue. Behold the body of the Most Holy Virgin Cecilia, whom I myself saw lying incorrupt in the tomb. I have in this marble expressed for you the same saint in the very same posture. Please subscribe to Catholic News World's YouTube channel. Thanks and God bless.